Hello everybody, welcome to today's session. I am Pradeepta Kumar. So guys, this is the tutorial number 7 of Kubernetes tutorial series. On today's session, we'll learn how to scaling up or scaling down deployments in Kubernetes. On last session guys, we had learned how to create a deployment in Kubernetes. So video has been uploaded, so you can browse to my playlist of Kubernetes. So you can watch that video. So guys, let's get started. So guys, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe now for more videos related to different cloud technology, different DevOps tool, VMware administration, Linux administration, and many more latest technology. So guys, before going with the lab session, just I want to give some overview related to scaling. So generally when you create a deployment for an application in Kubernetes, so we need to define the replica. So how many replica you want to create for the application. If you are not defining any replica, so by default it will take one replica for the application. Okay, you can define 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 as per your need. Okay, when you scale an application, you increase or decrease the number of replica. So that means you are scaling down or scaling up. That means you are scaling up means you are increasing the number of replica of the application. Scaling down means you are down the replica of the application. Okay, the replica count. Okay, scaling is done by increasing or decreasing the number of replica in a deployment. So scale up or scale down of deployment in Kubernetes can be in two ways, using kubectl, or if you have created your deployment using a manifest file, that also you can use. So guys, it's my advice that better you just watch the how to create deployment, how to set up clusters. There is series of video of Kubernetes. You just browse to my playlist. Okay, you will get all the videos so that it will be easy to understand this thing. Okay, so first example we'll see that how to scale the deployment. Okay, so I have already logged into my Kubernetes cluster. So kubectl get nodes. Okay, so this is two node cluster I have set up. So node 7, so which is in blue color, this is my master node, and this is my worker node. Okay, this is two node cluster. Okay, so guys, now we'll see what are the deployments. Okay, so if I'll give kubectl get deployments, so only one deployment. Okay, what is the replica set, what is the replica for this application? So get rs. okay, if you'll give, so currently replica count is 1. Okay, so this is my deployment. If you want to know more about the deployment and the replica, so you have to give kubectl get all hyphen o white, so it will give more information. So you can see, so this is the replica set. So then image is httpd, so I have used that http image for to create container. So this is the replica set. Okay, so this is my deployment. So this is the default one, this is default system services only. Okay, so Kubernetes service. Okay, so this is the pod. So inside the deployment, so one deployment, one pod. Because why one pod? Because the our replica count is 1. If I will increase the replica count to 2, so 2 pod will be created. Okay, so guys, so now we will increase. So if I'll give, so now currently this is my, so now replica count is 1. So I want to increase the replica count to 2. Okay, so simply I will just copy this thing, then I'll modify. So kubectl scale, so current replica is currently 1, then I want to increase the replica count to 2. Okay, so what is my deployment slash deployment name? So what is my deployment name? So this is my deployment name. Okay, you can give kubectl get deployment, so you will get the deployment name. Okay, test HTTPD. So let's see. So now it is saying scaled. So if I'll give kubectl get rs, now it is saying desired to current to ready 1. Okay, so after sometimes it will the ready state will be changed. Okay, ready to 2. Okay, so guys, now it has already changed. So you can see now the replica set desired is 2, current 2, ready 2. So earlierly when the replica set was 1, the pod was 1. Now replica set increased, so it created 2 pod, okay, 2 container. Okay, so you got right. So if I'll give QCTL get RS, so now it is desired 2, current 2 and ready 2. Okay, so now also we can scale down also. So simply, you know, for scale down you need to current replica is 2. Okay, I want to scale down to 1. Okay, simply we need to give this. Okay, so if I'll give RS, so now it's desired 1, current 1, ready 1. Okay, so now this is one way. Okay, another way, that if you have create your deployment using YML file, because in the last session I had show you that how to create a deployment using YML, that means using manifest file. So if you have manifest file, then also you can do. Okay, so last time what I will show you the manifest file through which I had created a deployment. So cd, so this is created. So okay, so this is my deployment YML file, okay, through which I had created a deployment. That time replica count was 1, deployment name was REST-HTTPD, then I had created it. So this is the manifest file for the deployment. So, okay, so you can use this manifest file for the to scale up and scale down. So what we'll do, simply I'll copy this thing. So kubectl, so before running, so if I'll give kubectl get RS, okay, now current desired is 1, current 1, ready 1. So simply I'll run kubectl scale. I want replica count to 2, okay, hyphen f, f for file, then the you have to give the YML file, the deployment YML file. Okay, so now you can see if I'll give net RS, so now it is saying desired to current to ready 1. Okay, if I'll give watch command, then it will take some time to, you know, come to ready state. Let's see. So now, you know, desired is 2, current 2, and after some time it will know the 2 pod will be launched and the replica count, the ready will change to 2. Okay, let's wait. So guys, in this way you can scale up, scale down your replica set. Okay, so now guys, you can see now that now both the replica is in ready state. Okay, so guys, you can, in this way you can do more practice, okay, so that you'll get more idea. So please stay tuned for next videos. Thank you very much.